Back to Hello Nigeria. Now, we apologize for that break in transmission from Abuja due to technical issues. It's time for us to look at our trending, our top story for today. Today on the show, we have a phenomenal woman, one who's not just an actor, but is also an author, an advocate for celibacy and waiting until marriage, and one who is fond of giving back. And she currently runs a school tour from school to school, sharing message about values and teaching young people how to be the great leaders that we need them to be. She's fondly known as Toyo Baby, but her name is Olayode Juliana, and she's our guest today. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Olive was saying that she's literally been waiting for you to come on the show for so long, so this is actually very special.
So finally, it's really special that we finally had you on the show.
Thank you for having me today.
So we know that many people know you as Toyo Baby, still know you as Toyo Baby, but you've been able to still build up your brand as Olayode Juliana. How has it been for you leaving Jennifer's Diary and standing on your own?
Well, it's been... I don't know exactly how to put it because I know that a lot of people still call me Toyo Baby. So I've just accepted that name as my other name because, I mean, friends still tease me and say Toyo Baby. And also, it's just the name that I have come to accept. Initially, I'll be so upset. I'm like, no, don't call me that. I'm not Toyo Baby. I'm Juliana. But now I just let people have their way. And I'm like, okay, Toyo Baby is not a bad name anyway. So, yeah, that's it.
And what has the experience been like since you left Jennifer's Diary? Now that you've come in as a solo actress, you're going forth in the industry. How's that been? What was the transition like for you?
Okay, I did not leave Jennifer's Diary, first of all. And in a series, characters come and go. So you just might see that Toyo Baby is back because according to the script, she traveled. So I did not leave the series. And people do series, people do movies, people do stage. So it just depends on what you want to do. You don't have to be in the series all the time. You can move from series to movies and move from movies to stage plays. Just as long as you enjoy acting, keep acting.
There were speculations then after you traveled from Jennifer's Diary. There were speculations about your relationship with not just Funke Akindele, but the team. So we want to clear the air. How's your relationship with her?
Aunt Funke and I are cool. I don't have a problem with Aunt Funke. And I don't know. Yeah, a lot of things, news stories on Instagram, different bloggers, all those people just like to talk so much. So,
how do you cope with that?
We're already used to it. You know, people hide behind a keypad saying all sorts about you. They know nothing about you. But, you know, they just want, they want to drive traffic to their blog and they want people to see what they're posting about. And so,
no, I'm saying that because everyone has their different ways or their different coping mechanisms when it comes to that. We had Shay Shay on the show and she told us how she always just turns lemons into lemonade. So as soon as bad things are out there in the media about her, she uses it to her advantage. We've seen that with other people as well. I know a recent example is Kylie Jenner and how, you know, she turned her basically her lip fillers into lip kits and now she's about to become a 21-year-old billionaire. What have you done and what do you do for yourself? What's your coping mechanism?
When I see people talking about me like that, I just freeze my tail. I'm like, okay, there's nothing I can do. They don't know me. So I freeze my tail. I don't bother replying them to say, hey, this is not it and this is it. I just let them talk. And two things, when people talk about you, good or bad, on social media, it's like they're giving you publicity. People go to your page, hey, what's happening? What's she saying? What's she not saying? So
it means you're relevant.
So it has an advantage. And the disadvantage is just that you're so upset. You're like, don't say that about me. That's not true. But, you know, at the end of the day, you calm down again and say,
emotional intelligence.
There's nothing I can do about this. I just have to move on and freeze my tail. They'll always talk. So
now, another thing they have talked about would be your... they've talked about your campaign against premarital sex. Now, you've been one person that has been known to champion the cause of virginity and waiting until marriage and celibacy for those who have had sex before, basically just pushing forward the idea of waiting until marriage. Now, you've been criticized because of this. So tell us, what has the criticism been like and what is the true position of things?
I am shocked as to how people react when they hear you talk about celibacy or keeping sex to your marriage, it's like a bug beats them or something. I'm like, chill, calm down, okay? So the reason why I'm an advocate of sexual purity first is because God told me to be an advocate of sexual purity many years ago when I did not even know I'd be an actress. God told me that he's going to give me a platform in the entertainment industry, and when he does, I should be an advocate of sexual purity. So we all have different things that God has instructed us to do. I'm a Christian, okay? I should say that.
That's totally
okay. So when I started acting, it was difficult. At some point, I'm like, do I want to do this? People are going to come after me and say, shut up. What are you saying? People are dying in the country. There's no food. I am talking about sexual purity. But again, it's God's business and we have to take it seriously. So people say also, people say, oh, why are you telling me not to have sex? Is it your life? Is it your business? Oh, okay, you don't want me to have sex. Do you think being a virgin is going to give you a good husband? They say also. But really, the major thing is God says keep sex till marriage, okay? And, God originated sex. God created sex. When you talk about these things, people just think like, maybe God doesn't want you to have sex. No, God wants you to have amazing sex, okay? But God is saying wait till marriage, okay? And people are like, okay, why should I wait till marriage? Why can't I just do what I want to do? I would say that when you get a phone, you read through the manual. You know, you want to know what the manufacturer says about it because you need to know how to make good use of the phone. And so the manufacturer of sex is saying, hey, keep sex till marriage. I think that's why we have problems in our marriages today. And I'm not saying that, hey, let me say it again, because some people watch this now, come and start dropping comments on my Instagram. Okay, I am not saying that being a virgin till marriage guarantees you the best marriage. No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying that doing it God's way is the perfect way, is the standard that we should all live by. And what hurts me the most is to see young people, teenagers, children already sexually active. And it's hurting because I'm like, you know, sex is beyond skin and skin. It's, your soul is involved, your mind is involved, you're putting a lot of things on the table. So it's not just your body, even my boyfriend, Paul. I love Paul so much. In 1 Corinthians, yes, it's my boyfriend. I wish there would be marriage in heaven because of that guy. I love him so much. He says it's beyond skin on skin. There's a lot, sex is I can go on and on talking about it, but it's something that we should keep till married because God says so, especially. And yeah, okay, thank you. You know what hurts me the most? Movies we see today, they say it's okay to meet somebody for the first time and you can have sex with that person. Some people are just partners. They are not in any relationship. They don't love each other. They are just together for sex. And, you know, music videos, all of a sudden, love has become sex. Such that even when you're seeing somebody singing, I love this girl, the next thing is they're showing them together on bed, da, 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 in bed or whatever. But that's not what sex is. I mean, sex is sacred. Sex is supposed to be kept till marriage because there's a lot. You know, it's like when you glue two things together, yeah, and then you separate it, it's no longer the same again. So imagine doing that with several guys, several girls. It's no longer the same. But, you know, that's why scripture says that, and the two shall become one. But when you do it with just one person, just how God wants it to be, you're honoring God and you're not even feeling guilty.
You mentioned about how our music videos and our movies are depicting love and sex. If you got a movie role where you had to have sex, will you accept
Why
it?
Would I do that? Oh, gosh.
You
don't want to know how many roles I have. You don't want to know how many roles I've turned down because of that. I don't do it. And, you know, some people just run their mouth and say, we've not been seeing Juliana, she's no more acting, blah, blah, blah. They don't have an idea because it is something I believe in and I can't do it.
Even if you were acting as a married person.
I can't do it.
And it was just make-believe.
Thing is, they say make-believe, but it is you acting it, okay? It is you acting it, so let's not talk about that. Okay. Because my boss will watch this and they'll call me after.
So, so we take two things off the list, actress and also an advocate for celibacy. But we haven't spoken about the fact that you're also an author and you wrote a book called Rebirth. Mm. Tell us what stemmed I don't want to say, I was about to say, what stemmed you coming to write that book? But in better words, tell us what stemmed or your belief for you actually writing that book. I don't even know if I still worded that right, but I think you get my point.
I do. Okay. First of all, God told me to write the book. It was a struggle because I didn't want anybody reading about me. I don't know, somehow some people enjoy being in the news, people talking about them all the time. They even create scandals so that you talk about them. But I just like my life really quiet. And that's why I love Genevieve so much. So much. I love her. Okay. Yeah. I just like living a quiet life. And so when God instructed me to do it, I just said, you know, somehow, sometimes God tells you to do something, but you don't want to do it because he will not come from heaven to pull you, to hold you down. So I just said, okay, I've had it. I'll do it when I'm ready. But then I kept seeing it, you know, because, okay, I have different gifts, yeah. So let's, before people say this is every time, why talk is spiritual? I'm a Christian, I've said that earlier. Okay, so every time I pray, I kept seeing myself writing about myself. You know, people started telling me, God told you to do something, you are refusing to do it, blah, blah, blah. So I'm like, okay, God, before you go about telling people about me and you want to discuss the secrets, let me just write it. So I wrote the book because I wanted to tell the truth again. On social media, I tell people that I'm an advocate of sexual purity, and a lot of people think that I'm a virgin because I advocate sexual purity, which is not so. I know that some people, when they ask me before I wrote my book, I won't say no and I won't say yes. So that makes them believe that, okay, since she's advocating sexual purity, that means she's a virgin. So I was tired of not telling the truth. And I was, okay, I think twice, or I can't remember when, I think twice people asked me directly in an interview like this, live, are you a virgin? I'm like, this is the first time anybody's asking that. I didn't even think before I said yes. And I don't like lying. It hurts me. When I got back home that day, I was crying. I'm like, oh, Juliana, how long do you want to continue like this? I think you're telling the truth will help somebody out there know that, hey, even if you've done it before, you can still stay sexually pure and still keep sex till marriage. So I brought my pen out and my book and I started writing. I closed it for some time. I opened it again because it brought back memories of how I lost my virginity, memories of childhood and everything that I just didn't want to remember, things that I've swept beneath my carpet and I'm like, I'm never going back to this. But hey, I remember, people have been blessed by it. Just 2 days ago, I was somewhere and somebody walked up to me and said, hey, you know what? I've decided to stay sexually pure because I read your book. I'm like, are you kidding? And of course, one of the secondary schools, I went for the Rebirth secondary school tour. So I was telling them, I said, hey, you don't have to sleep with anybody to make money, because there was a time when I thought that I can't be rich. So I would rather, maybe I'll just get married to a rich man, you know, and he'll take care of me. Or I'll be somebody's house help, maybe a rich man's house help. That was all I thought of myself. And hey, when I'm his house help, maybe when I'm so good to him, he'll take care of me. And then when they're traveling out of the country, I'll go everywhere. That was all I saw Juliana to be at a point. So I was telling them that you don't have to think of being a rich man's wife to be rich. You can make your money yourself and you don't have to sleep with anybody. And so she walked up to me after and said, you know, I have been in a relationship with a married man for 3 years now, and she's 16.
Wow.
So because you said she was weeping, I tell you, I can't be a counselor because I was crying. I'm like, you know, the power of words. You don't even know who you're saving just by saying these things. And I'm like, I am so proud of you that you say that you're not doing this anymore because Juliana is telling you this morning, or has told you this morning, to stay away from me. So there's a lot.
It's really exciting to see that by sharing the truth of your life, you're able to reach out to other lives as well. Mm-hmm. What would you say keeps you going, continuing doing what you do? Because the truth is, I'm wondering, sometimes don't you ever get scared that you're advocating celibacy? What happens to you if one day you fall? Does that thought ever cross your mind? And how do you deal with it?
Of course, a lot of times. My father is an advocate of sexual purity. I have two fathers. When you read my book, you get to know. I have my biological father and I have another father, Timilenga Adigun. I love him so much. I love his wife so much. Okay, let me not go there. Okay, so and then in my ministry, the ministry that I came from, we are strong advocates of sexual purity. So there's nothing like having people that you can draw strength from when you're weak and when you're like, am I really sure that this message is worth it? Am I really sure that I don't want to quit? Because, hey, you'll be faced with a lot of things that will make you want to quit. And some people don't even want to be in a relationship with you. If you don't want to have sex with them, I don't even want to talk about that.
No, maybe we should talk about that for a little bit. Have you ever experienced situations where they outrightly told you, people you liked, that they couldn't date you unless you had sex with them?
Well, not people I liked, okay? Older people, like older men. You know, you just go to them, telling them about what you want to do, and they're like, okay, come to my room, come here, let's meet here. I'm like, is this all men think about? Sex?
You know what? It's actually so funny, because there's one thing my father said to me this morning. He said, you don't need to go to any man's house. Any man that says, come to my house, even if that one is friend, you don't need to go. Mm-hmm. Because it's so easy for them to want you to just be there so that they feel like you're sending across a message, and one thing can lead to another.
Of course.
So there's so many things that you can actually do to prevent yourself from even having to experience that in the first
Absolutely.
Place. What would you say has been the hardest thing for you, though, in all of this? What has been the hardest or most challenging thing?
The most challenging for me is, okay. I don't want to get really emotional. The most challenging for me that makes me ask God over and over again, God, do you really want me to do this? Are you sure you don't want to change your mind or give this assignment to somebody else? Is that it's so difficult to preach this message in this generation with this culture. And, you know, people look at you like, are you mad? Why are you doing this? And you get jobs, you get people sending you scripts, you can't take it because you can't do what they want you to do. And you're like, okay, is this really what entertainment is all about these days? Do we have to do these things? And we forget that there are people, young ones, watching us, looking up to us because they just want to see what we are doing and follow our footsteps. And, you know, you see people out there posting on social media to say, it's okay if you love somebody, you can have sex with that person. You're not telling the truth. You're covering up your own mistake, leading somebody else to make the same mistake. And I'm like, it's okay to say I did wrong and I'm where I am today, but keep sex till marriage. And so it's so challenging for me because people then talk and run their mouth and say, hey, she's not working anymore. She's not doing anything anymore. She's just there. Like, you don't have a clue how many things I've had to turn down because of my belief. And I will still continue to do that as God helps me.
And that is your strength.
Yes, because I'm not going to change it for anybody because, hey, everything in this world will fade away.
Yeah.
The hard work, the everything, the fame you want to have, you want to be in every movie, you want to be everywhere, it will end here. So what matters, what I tell myself every time is, hey, Juliana, you are not even going to be here forever. So invest in a place where you'll be forever and forget about these people, forget about this place, because I won't always be here. So that's the most challenging thing so far. Rejecting jobs and people are talking about you. They don't know nothing. But I know, again, because God is a God that keeps to his promises. God has said, hey, Juliana, I'm not done with you yet. So I totally believe in him. And I'm not in a hurry. I'm going to go through the process. I'm not even competing with anybody.
And having a boyfriend that understands you. Like, having a boyfriend that understands you must also really help.
Yes, must also really help. But
do you
cry
like this all the time? Just so you guys know, in case the camera can't pick it, she's been tearing up seriously. And I must say that it's okay to cry. You know, it's okay to deal with the reality of the challenges that you're going through.
Mm-hmm.
You understand that it's a different world.
Mm-hmm.
But why fit in when you can stand out?
Yeah.
So you're standing out and you're preaching a message, which I think will help a lot of people, you know. There's so many diseases that could be avoided. Mm-hmm. So many unwanted pregnancies could be avoided. Mm-hmm. So many suicides would be avoided because people would think, how did you break up with me after I gave
Depression.
You my body? You know,
yeah.
So many things can be avoided. Mm. And people will communicate more if you took sex out of the picture.
Absolutely.
Because at the end of the day, you don't even know this person that much, because all you do sometimes in some relationships is just spending time in sexual intercourse. Whereas take that out of the picture and see what exactly you have. Mm-hmm. So I know there are many people, many young people, who are watching and thinking, I want to be like Juliana. You've become a voice that has inspired people to want to wait, to keep themselves. But I'm sure you also deal with urges just like every other person else. So if you're watching a little boy or girl that wanted to wait, what are the tips? What would you say to them? What are the words of encouragement? The do's and the don'ts, if there are.
Okay, I would say have the right friends. Have the right friends. Don't, friends, they can, they are your backbone. They are your pillar. So the kind of friends you have, they have to believe in what you believe in. They have to agree with you. They have to support you. Then, even if you don't have friends, because sometimes your friend can say to you, hey, you haven't done too much. What happened? How did you do this life? Have the word of God. You are never alone. Never, 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 never. Scripture says, I will be with you to the end of the world. Even when you feel like you are the only one here and there is nobody supporting you, there is nobody encouraging you, you have Jesus. Just listen. Be calm and listen. He's supporting you, he's cheering you on. He's saying, go girl, I'm proud of you. Go girl, go girl, go girl. Hey, so yeah, you need to just, you need to have good friends. You need to have the word of God and you need to know that you are never alone, and I am with you, even though I've not seen you, even though I don't know you, but you're never alone.
And we are with you as well here. Yeah. Thank you so much.
All I've been thinking all this time is I have a book that you need to read. Like, that's literally all that's been on my mind. This has been so inspirational. Thank you.
And we also would like to read your book. So how can people get information on where to get your book?
Okay, you can get, I think I put it up for free at some point when some people started selling it on WhatsApp groups and... I'm like, let him just have it. But you can get a hard copy at, you can get the hard copy. Ah, gosh, Juliana, I can't believe I can't remember.
Latana?
No.
Okay, so maybe one
Hataba
would...
books.
Okay.
You can get it on Okada Books as well, if you want Okada Book. You can get it on Amazon. You can get it on... Or you know what? You can just check...
Your Instagram as well.
Check my Instagram, yes.
So
yes.
I'm sure you'd have a more elaborate list of all the places that one can get your books.
Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
We have been joined with Olayode Juliana Toyo Baby, a woman of strength, a woman of virtue, a woman of valor, who has decided to stand out from the crowd rather than blending. I mean, why blending when you can stand out? And it's been a very eye-opening and challenging conversation. Thank you very much for joining
us.
Thank you.
We wish you all the best.
Thank you.
And we hope that you're on the days when you're crying and we can't see and nobody can see, that you'll be strengthened to continue in this journey. And you actually give me hope for our generation, because I used to say that I'm scared of having kids in this generation.
No.
But knowing that there are people like you gives me hope to want to have kids in this generation.
Philippians 4:13. That's literally all that I've been thinking about.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.